Because we know there's nothing greater in life than Amal HaTorah. Learning Torah in a high level with devotion is superb in the eyes of Hashem. He loves it very much. Then on the other hand, when you ask, what's the purpose of life? Why we even have Torah to begin with? The answer is to make us very decent human being. The Torah's job, the Torah is a remedy to the corrupted behavior of people. When they come to the world, one is with ego and pride and anger and selfishness and laziness and stinginess and all kinds of problems. Every baby has come to the world with his traits. Some are worse than others. Now we have the Torah, which can fix things, can turn them less angry, more generous, less lazy, fighting against their evil inclination, learning to behave in a better way, having faith, having strong mentality, counting on Hashem and not break in hard situation. The Torah is a treasure. So what was the purpose of the Torah? That you'll be knowledgeable? No. The purpose of the Torah was that you will be a decent human being. So if you go to increase your Torah level and at the same time there is external bad influence on you, you defeat the purpose. It's a downgrade. It's not an upgrade. Because in the end, if someone's Torah's level is not the highest, but his manners are perfect, as opposed to someone that his Torah knowledge is the highest, but his personality is corrupted, which one of the two is going to heaven? Not the one with the high skills in Torah. The one with the perfect personality and behavior. So what do we see from here? The purpose, the achievement in life should be that you leave this world a mensch. What does it mean, a mensch? A very decent human being. Calm, relaxed, not angry. Speak with respect to everyone. Don't put people down. Don't have chutzpah. Pay on time. Don't cheat people in a business. Doesn't matter, Jews or non-Jews. Never yell, never scream, never say one word of curse in your own entire life. Never. Never, ever. No matter how angry someone just got you. Control your personality. Control your desire for food. Your desire for materialism. All the addictions the world has to offer. Get up in the morning early. Even if sometimes you sleep late, because sometimes you have to go to a wedding, your brother, your cousin. By the time you go to bed, it could be 2 a.m. You have to wake up early again. And you have to have order in your life. The schedule, you have to make yourself a schedule. Time to learn, time to eat, time to be with the family, time to work. According to what you choose to do in your life, but you have to be consistent. The only people that succeed big time in life are people that are organized in their schedule. They are organized. Rav Eliashiv, 60 years, was learning in the same place in yeshiva with the standard, and everybody knew what time he will sit down and open the Gemara, what time he will get up and close the Gemara. It was like a robot, like a machine. You know, your computer, you always know what's going to happen when you press this button. There's no surprises. You know what will happen. This is how he was. And that's why he became the greatest rabbi in the whole world. How? Consistency.